Welcome to this week's edition of East Wake News. I'm Nicole Turner. The Knightdale 100 will once again be hosting an education forum in Tower Raising the Roof, challenging Knightdale's best and brightest. The forum to be held at Knightdale Town Hall will take place on March 22nd from 6 to 8 p.m. Brian Cooper, Duke University Talent Identification Program Director, will be the forum's keynote speaker. For more information, call the Knightdale Chamber of Commerce at 266-4603. With spring here, be sure to learn how you can add wildlife to your yard and community. Join the East Regional Library for a diverse plant landscape presentation on Tuesday, March 20th at 7 p.m. And May, an education with the North Carolina Wildlife Commission will offer suggestions on how to increase wildlife at your home and in your neighborhood. For more information, stop by the library in Knightdale or call 217-5300. Next month, Sheila Prosser will begin a journey with the grand opening of Dream Cope Ministries, a program designed to help people get back on their feet after suffering life-altering events. The ministries will be located behind Bojangles in Knightdale and will provide new and gently used clothing along with small household items like bedding and pots and pans available for purchase. The proceeds will be used to help pay for the overhead. With the help of donations and grants through the United Methodist Churches, they will be able to open the store. For more information, call Sheila Prosser at 889-9045. A diverse group of Catholics came together last week to in dedication of the brand new St. Eugene Catholic Church Sanctuary in Wendell. The two-hour dedication service was held in two languages for a congregation that was 60% Hispanic, evidence of a growing faith in the Triangle. The new 600-seat St. Eugene Sanctuary has been 10 years in the making. Similar building projects are in the works all over the Triangle, caused by an influx of Hispanic immigrants, retirees from North, and professionals from all over U.S. and need a larger churches. The faith is also making converts, with 900 people Eastern North Carolina set to join this Easter. Jordan Tyndall, a senior of East Wake Academy and daughter of Sue and Ken Tyndall, spent last weekend at the Southeastern Theater Conference's annual convention in Chattanooga, Tennessee, where she received the 2012 High School Play Project Award. Tyndall wrote a one-act play for an independent theater study class called Forgotten, about a college student whose mother brings her sick grandmother to live with them. The mother and daughter then have to come to terms with realization that the grandmother is suffering from Alzheimer's disease. When completed the play in October, the school's theater class held a read-through, and then a classmate's perform the play as stage reading at the school's fall art show. Congratulations to Jordan Tyndall on a job well done. In sports, former Knightdale pitcher Michael Green helped lead Brunswick Community College to a 10-0 win over New River Community College on March 3rd. Green, a 2010 graduate of Knightdale High School, threw the first perfect game in the five-year history of Brunswick baseball. He threw 47 pitches to 15 batters and struck out six in the win. The following game, Michael Green threw a second straight perfect game against Patrick Henry Community College batter. Green signed last year with Winthrop University, where he will join the Division I program this fall. Thanks for watching this edition of East Wake News. I'm Nicole Turner.